Today's topic is one that I'm particularly excited about, because on this episode, we're going to be taking a look at technology and the family. We're going to explore some ways to make it work for your family rather than letting it take over. Hi, I'm Ryan, and you're in the Family Support Circle. Technology can be used in a healthy family. The key is we have to be proactive in defining the role that we want it to play in the family. And like all things when it comes to families, the best way to address problems is to plan for them before they're problems. So how do we do that with technology? It's actually not that complicated. You do that by working together with the people in your home to create a family technology plan. And don't worry, I've done most of the hard work for you. The plan we're going to look at today can be downloaded from a few different places and edited to fit your family's needs, but we'll get to all that later. Let's start by just taking a look at how this can work in your family. The first thing I want you to know is that how you create the tech plan is a vital piece to whether or not it's going to be successful in your home. Don't present this to your kids as something you've created that they now have to agree to. Instead, let it be a conversation, and a conversation that everybody gets to be a part of. In fact, that's one of the best parts. It gets you talking about something with your family that typically doesn't come up unless somebody's upset. The plan needs to be created through negotiation and agreement. Otherwise, it won't work. And with that in mind, I present to you the Family Technology Plan. This particular tech plan is done menu style, and when finished, can be printed and cut that way. I did this because the plan itself is divided into sections. Notice the first section is titled Every Day, Everyone. This is where you agree to some family norms about how technology will be used. For example, you set a time where devices will be turned off. You also specify here that devices will not be out at the dinner table. Then we move on to the kids section. These are standards that apply specifically to kids in the house. If you're tired of your teenager staring at a screen when you ask about their day, this is the place to address it. You'll also notice I put a policy of no secret accounts here. You may think this is a no-brainer, and I hope it is, but I still want you to say it out loud to your kids. Have a conversation about it. You may learn some things. Now we move on to the parent section. Hey, I'm an equal opportunity counselor, and this isn't just a kid problem. The parent section is a place for couples to address their own concerns and for kids to address theirs as well. Dads, is she on Facebook the second the kids leave the room? Put it in the tech plan. Mom, is he checking fantasy football stats constantly? Put it in the tech plan. Do your kids get frustrated when you post embarrassing pictures of them without their consent? Put it in the tech plan. Let them tell you what they'd like to see from you, just like you do with them. Look, these things aren't inherently bad, but decide when it's okay and when you can agree to put the phones down. Just like with the kids, talk. Give a little here and there and find that happy medium that works for everyone. These sections are all editable, so feel free to customize it, but I gave you an idea to include a special section for social media. This section is a wonderful starting point for a conversation about how to use it and how not to use it. Don't be mean to people online. I know, it's a no-brainer, but I still want you to say it out loud and discuss it with your kids. These are topics that only seem to be addressed when someone's done something wrong, and that's not good. Now, I know what you're thinking. This all sounds great, but there's no way my family could stick to this. So what happens when we fail miserably on day one? Don't you worry, I got you covered. Near the signature page is a section titled Slip-Ups. In this section, you assign consequences for every policy based on number. In the example, if a kid violates policy 4 through 9, they lose their device for 48 hours. This completely eliminates the need for you, the parent, to let violations slide because you don't really know how to address it. Everyone knows in advance that if you get a phone out at dinner, it's going to cost you 24 hours. It's right there in the plan and was agreed to and signed off on. One other note, confiscating devices as a consequence can lead to some pretty ugly scenes. Here's a free piece of advice. Include in your tech plan a reminder that if a child willingly hands over their device without arguing, the penalty time gets cut in half. They still have a consequence, but they get to practice the concept that how you respond to mistakes will directly impact the fallout. The last thing I want to point out is the signatures page. Everyone needs to sign it, but no one should be forced to. If your kid is unhappy and doesn't want to sign it, ask why. Ask them to be specific. What do they want to change? I'm not asking you to let go of something you feel is important. Just continue to discuss it and negotiate until they're more comfortable. Remind them that they need to meet you halfway, because while you're willing to let them be a part of creating the tech plan, you're not willing to throw it out. So that's it. Like I said, it's actually not that complicated. So where do you get your completely free downloadable family tech plan? There are actually two places. The easiest is right here where you're probably watching this video, www.mesquiteisd.org. If you look under the video, you'll see it right there labeled Family Technology Plan. It's a Word document, so you can edit it for whatever works best for your family. The other place is www.yourbestfamily.com. There's a link on the homepage that explains the process and also provides a completely blank version. If you're absolutely technophobic, download the blank one and just do the whole thing by hand. Okay, you've heard the instructions and you've got access to the plan. All that's left is for you to talk to your family, and I'm not doing that for you. However you find it and however you choose to do it, do it. Reclaim family time. Put technology in its place. And be closer. I'm Ryan, and I'll see you next time on the Family Support Circle.